So I'm going to Tim McGee. Thank you.
Just before I start, I just want to thank you all for coming. This is the first one in Huddersfield, hopefully not the last one. So tell everyone after this one that you've enjoyed it, hopefully. And then we'll have more people next time. Just a little caveat, I just get it to next time, but I'm sure it won't be. Okay, right. I'm going to talk to you about professional normals. As you might have noticed, I'm from the north. I've got a really, really dodgy accent, and a lot of people from the south, i.e. Chesterfield, I'm going to talk about I'm going to try and tell you who I think my professional North is. The North is not here. That's not the North. That is, where's that? Kind of Leicester way? I'm not really miles off. I'm not sure, but that's definitely not North. It's not there. But people from London kind of think it is, but it's not there either. The North is, that's some sort of Viking land. That's not the North. I mean, it's the North East thing. I don't know the way they're closed. It's just a really weird place, so it's not that. It's the real North, but this is the North for me. It's not this side either. It's not that's Manchester, but again, I don't think they're really North. It's Manchester, Liverpool, probably that North. It's not some sort of weird breed, I don't think that's the North at all. So what is a professional Northern North? It's definitely not. It's definitely not the chap here. He's got a jump around his... shoulders, for God's sake. He's got a delicate bowl of nuts and a glass of Chardonnay. So what makes a professional Northerner? It's definitely that other guy. It's somebody who's just who's a passionate person who's probably from, I don't know, around here. I'm from Sheffield, so not beating up too much. I live in Leeds, so again, don't beat me up too much, because you guys are kind of not close. So professional Northerners are definitely miserable, as most of the sort of wine country shows. They're pretty independent. They kind of articulate, or at least think they're articulate, i.e. most northern men, and this is more mainly men, will tell you exactly what they think. They're argumentative. Just look at like Arthur Scoggin. You couldn't get anyone any more argumentative than Arthur Scoggin. They're pretty brutal, again. Not they're quite out how artistic Arthur is, guessing he's not, really. They're male. Every time. So who are our potential candidates? There's a few around here. I'm gonna kind of talk through who I think who the candidates are, and then there'll be a big reveal, or maybe a small reveal, depending on so this is the first one, Jimmy Savile, definitely from Leeds, he's definitely a Northerner, he's a professional, not entirely sure what, he's obviously runs and raises money for charity, but he's a bit dodgy really, and I'm sure that he actually hides the fact he's from Leeds, I know he goes around there and everything. Now, a lot of people don't know Brian West is from Yorkshire, but I think you should be really proud of Brian Blessed. Again, another man who disguises the fact he's from Yorkshire. He sounds nothing like a Yorkshireman to me, whatever, apart from when he shouts and wails or whatever. This, for anyone who doesn't know, this is Marquis Smith. He's very artistic, ridiculously miserable, and really argumentative. He will shout at you all night. However, Mark's from Manchester. Sorry. No Manchester people, because it's not the same. Morrissey, again, he is articulate, he's creative. Everybody loves, well, people kind of love him, he's obviously a bit, he has other people, but again, he's from Manchester, and all that daffodil waving is great, but he's not really that Northern, I don't think, me personally. Now, David Hockney, obviously, he's from Bradford, he's a professional Northerner, because he's very good, and he's very proud of the county, and all these other things, but he spent a lot of time in LA, down poles and stuff, and I don't know, it's off. Again, a brilliant professional Northerner. But again, somebody who, for me, isn't really that Northern in his outlook, because again, there's all this footlights business going on and down in theatre land in London. I don't know how much he does in Yorkshire. Paul Heaton. Now, for me, Paul Heaton is very, very close to being a professional Northerner. He's a Sheffield United fan, which is great. Unfortunately, he's from Hull. Is that the North? Is that Yorkshire? I'm not entirely sure. So Paul's a bit broken that one. Now, Sean Bean, one for the ladies. Again, he's from Sheffield, and he makes his acting career out of that, being this thick northern gruff bloke. But he all seems a bit false. I know he's tattooed. Oh, so, I don't know, it's a heresy. It's only my upset people. Now, Jarvis, me being from Sheffield, and I was in the same scout troop as Jarvis. So I really love Jarvis. I've got a lot of time for Jarvis. But again, he spends a lot of time in that there London, and I think a lot of time in that Paris as well. So. Maybe he's not quite as good as he should be. That's my professional Northerner, Brian Glover. Born in Barnsley, he was a wrestler. He was the team man, for Christ's sake. He was the football master in Kes. And you couldn't get anyone more northern than Brian Blessing. And look at this. The northern people say what they think. You place your strength in this game, Manchester, a bolder, rough-looking Yorkshireman. How much more professional northern can you get than Brian? So there you go. This is my professional northern. I'm sure some of you don't agree, but there you go.